Josh.
I'm Josh as well.
And today I'm going to be Big Cook.
And I'm Little Cook.
And we're going to be showing you how to cook fajitas at home. So if you've got the ingredients, make sure you've got them ready. We're going to take you through it step by step. Hopefully at the end, you've got a delicious plate of lovely fajitas. Mm. Josh, what are you going to be prepping over here for us?
Okay, so let's start off with the chicken. This is quite an orthodox method, but we're going to be using scissors. Take the chicken breast like this. We cut it in the middle. And then we can cut it again.
This is wrong.
Something's not wrong.
Okay. Cool. So whilst Josh is getting on with that, let me take you over to the chopping board. So here we have one whole Spanish onion, and I've taken the skin off of it. It's a white one, and this is essentially the best way to dice an onion without getting any tears and also without any mess. So as you can see, I chopped off that side, which is just the head of the onion. This side is the core. We want to keep that intact with your knife. Nice and confident. You're going to go take it down the middle, okay? One big. Now you've got half an onion. But as you can see, the core is still in place, which is going to help us as we go long strokes down the onion, okay? We're never hitting the end of the onion. We're just going about 80% to the end. Nice and confident, guys. Don't be afraid of the knife, is what I always say. Now that we've got a fan, as you can see, they all separate. We're going to be cutting the onion laterally along the bottom. We're going to do three strokes. So we're going to go right along the bottom. We're going to go right through the middle, like this. I'm going to do a cheeky one on top as well. Now that we've done that, just go nice, quick strokes down. Now, if your diced onion hasn't come out as diced as you wanted, what you can do is gather them into a pile and just chop it like this until you get it to the desired diameters. We have two cloves of garlic here. You can like finely chop it like this, but actually I don't actually enjoy that method. So what we're going to do is we're going to crush the garlic. Here's a chili. We're going to half the chilies here. Now, I had one of these chilies earlier, and actually they're fairly spicy. So fair play. We're not going to put too many in. We should probably put one in. But here's a hack. If you like the taste of chili, but don't want your tongue to go numb, most of the spice in the chili is the seeds and the pith, I believe it's called. The pith? The white bits inside. So what we're going to do is we halved it, and then we're just going to scrape it out. Either with a knife, like this, and you can take off the end, and then scrape the other side, making sure that they go into the sink where they belong. But don't flick all your garlic into the sink like I just did. Now that you've got... Oh, I've just gone in my eye. I just flew into my eye.
I started to cry. Yeah.
Look at my eyes. My eyes. I'm going to do nice little long strands. You got milk, mate?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm just doing a rough chop. Keep them rustic. Let your fajitas have a bit of attitude. Now, this was controversial to many at first, but I'm going to show you what happens. With bell peppers, they usually grow in segments of three. Actually, if you want to have a little bit of banter, you can just rip these segments off like this. If you're not very good with a knife. But if you've got one of these bad boys, chop down the segments. And what actually you avoid by doing this is any of that bitter white stuff in the seeds. It's all intact. No mess. No hassle. So we've got three bits of pepper segment here. I'm just going to show you the best way to do it. What you want to do, have three fingers like this. Put your middle finger in front of your other two fingers and curve them. What essentially is going to happen is your knife is never going to leave that part of your hand, so you can chop in complete safety. So as you see, like that, thumb on the back, and then you get this nice long slices. And it's absolutely no hassle at all. So I thought we'd just let you know, right now Josh is preheating the pan. We're doing fried fajitas, so he's basically put the pan on 5 or 6. So once you've got them julienned, I think that's actually the right term, I could be wrong. Basically long strips, you want to gather them up, line them up, like the peppers they are. And then you just want to do confident little downstrokes, going through them all. And now you've got diced pepper. If you're people from other, like, so I think most English people I know like diced peppers in their fajitas. If you're from somewhere else and diced peppers offend you, you can just leave them long.
We should have waited until it's hot.
We put some oil in. First thing that's going to go into your pan are your onions, and your onions alone. If you've got a cold pan, which ours is heating up, this is perfectly fine to do right now. Despite what other people would say. We're using the spatula. You can use a spoon, a wooden spoon. I wouldn't recommend it because wooden spoons take on the flavor of whatever they're cooking. So over time, your food's going to start tasting the same. So these guys, they clean up real nice. I think they're better. I'd recommend that. So your onions are going to start to get hot. They're going to start to saute. Just keep them moving in the pan. You don't want them to burn. As it starts to heat up, we're going to add the beginning of our flavor profile to our chicken. And the first thing you want to do, it is optional, but I'm going to put a little bit of tomato paste, tomato puree. And what you're going to do is you're going to put a bit of that, not too much, in with the onions. If you don't have tomato paste, you can put ketchup in at this point. You could crush actual tomatoes in, but paste is going to give you a nice tomatoey body to your onions.
Nice bit of sea salt.
So Josh, how long have you been a professional chef?
Years really. Started off with Jamie Oliver, you know.
Oh yeah, of course.
Then we went to Gordon Ramsay, but so he couldn't handle the heat. With me in the kitchen.
Of course.
Yeah, and then moved on to Nigella Lawson now.
Oh, we all love Nigella, don't we?
Yeah.
So where are you working now, Josh?
Have
you run out of famous chefs to mention?
No, I'm working with Marco P.A. White, you know. In his steakhouse somewhere in London. Quite exclusive.
That sounds brilliant.
Yeah.
What we're doing now is just we're laying our chicken in to those onions and the tomato paste. They're smelling, it's smelling gorgeous, Josh, isn't it?
Yeah.
Smelling gorgeous. It smells like Spain. So what we're going to do now is we're going to let the chicken sit in the pan. This is the only opportunity it's going to get a nice brown colouring, a bit of character, a bit of char. It's starting to go white around the edges. When you see it going white, it's almost ready for you to start flipping it over. Because we're at that time, we're going to add our spices.
So we're going to start with hot chili powder. How hot do you like it?
Oh, mate, I love spice. Nothing seems to make
okay
a fajita better than a bit of spice. This is where you would add your cumin. We don't have cumin, so we're going to add turmeric. We gave you some basic spices to make it decent, quite palatable, but it's really up to you to make your fajitas. We're going to add some lemon juice. It's going to smoke, but it's going to leave such a wonderfully citrus aroma on the chicken. Stir it around now. And once we've stirred it around, you're going to see that the chicken has developed just a sensational crust, a bark of flavor. We're going to let that fry. We're going to turn the heat down a little bit. And here we're going to add the rest of that chopped vegetables into the mix.
So I just broke this chicken in half. As you can see, white all the way through, which is why we wanted to stop the cooking the frying process. The chicken is cooked. Now our chief aim is to retain the moisture of the bird. And we're going to do that by adding not too much liquid, but moisture to the pan. So one easy way to do that is if you have a lid, put it on a lower heat and put the lid on, leave it there for about 10 minutes, stirring it occasionally. We're going to keep it open and we're going to take the opportunity to add even more flavour to our chicken mix. It's unbelievable, it's even more flavour. You know, if you're ever unsure about if your chicken is cooked, just leave it in another minute if you're unsure, because chicken that's undercooked can be really dangerous. Now becomes the most important part. This is ready. The chicken is ready to be consumed. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn the heat off, put a lid on it.
So we're going to heat up the fajitas. We've got lovely prepared from Tesco's. Put in, I would generally put in one or two.
Right.
And then you go for the middle.
Josh is out.
Okay. Sorry, chef. Sorry, chef.
You're little cook, I'm big cook.
So place that in the middle and leave it for probably under a minute until it's nice and warm. You don't want it to go crispy because then it just falls apart when you try to fold it.
Yeah. If you look down here, we've got an array of different accoutrements. What I'm doing is just doing long strokes. We've got one more pepper here. I'm going to show you how we do it at McDonald's. So we would usually have a sauce at McDonald's, but a separate sauce, but we've got the sauce in the chicken. So don't worry about that. What we're going to do is two bits of cucumber as a wall that's going to contain our chicken in the correct zone. We're gonna load up some pepper because it's healthy, it's crunchy, it's citrusy, it's perfect for what we're going for. Now, I love coleslaw and I'm not a big fan of, sour cream or guacamole. So what I do, as a personal life choice, which you don't need to get involved with, is I put coleslaw in my fajitas. Josh, do you have anything to say about that?
That's rogue.
It's rogue.
Too rogue. I think you need to put a bit of tomato puree in
there, maybe. Tomato, mate.
Spread across the base.
You're supposed to be a chef. You're embarrassing yourself. I'm going to layer that coleslaw on top of those. And you don't have to do this. If you don't like this, don't do it. Don't put yourself through that. Oh, have a look at that. Have a look at that. Aren't you jealous? If you're cooking along as you should be, you won't be jealous because it will be right in front of you. Classic mistake I see people making is overstuffing their fajitas. You ain't going to be able to roll it up, mate. Only put what you need. There's far more tortillas than you'll ever need. I don't have, in all of your years of professional chefing, have you ever run out of tortillas before you run out of chicken?
Never.
Exactly. You won't run out of tortillas. No. You will run out of chicken. So I would recommend you being patient and being perhaps a little bit conservative with your chicken placement.
Maybe a little drizzle of lemon juice.
Josh, I couldn't agree more. Put your thumb over the top to control it. That's beautiful. Have you got? I like a bit of chili flake on the already spicy beans. Just sprinkle it what you want. And now here's the most important bit: ending it with the wrap. This wrap, you want to make sure it hasn't stuck to your board. Just get a little. This is important. So as you can see, I've left about an inch room on both sides. Because when you do this first initial push here, it's going to move up. So you want to allow for that. So what you're going to do, you've made a line, you're going to fold it at the bottom, going to pinch here. You're going to pull it over all the way and pull it back on itself. See this? There's nothing over here now. Nothing. No spillage. No crying. No problems. Once you've done that, you're going to tuck it all the way over. Now, you can pick that up. As you see, perfectly wrapped. Rock solid at the bottom. You won't get any leakage. Josh, would you care to? Would you care to show that anyone, even a non... I mean, you're a professional chef.
Yeah, obviously.
But you can hold that.
Yeah.
And there is absolutely no leakage.
No.
I mean, you could even...
Yeah.
Even... Look at that. Upside down. Nothing fell out. See that? Tight. They teach you that at McDonald's, mate. First day. So now what we're going to do is there's so much to teach them, Josh.
Oh, no. Not enough time.
So what you can do now is you can do this, or if you're feeling particularly generous, you can share it with your friend. Okay. You're not going to eat it. Josh?
Cheers.
Cheers. Ah! Oh, that is so delicious.
That is spicy.
So,
enjoy with a nice glass of professional.
No, I'm fine. So what you can expect, you're just hit with the lemon. It's not obtrusive. It's not too much. Josh isn't eating because he's actually vegetarian.
Yeah. That's so good.
I don't know what I would do without the coleslaw because it's horrendously spicy. But that's how I like it.
It's so spicy.
It's one of my glasses.
Yeah.
Why are you choosing my glass?
I don't know.
It's clean. So we've made the you see, we put chili in and chili powder. And then I put chili flakes on it. And we also put that in it. Hot fajita seasoning. So maybe don't put every form of chili you can on the chicken. I'm actually enjoying the spice. I like the way it feels dancing on your tongue, but you can reduce that to your own taste. Josh, it's been a pleasure.
It's been a pleasure, Rob, mate.
I hope you've enjoyed the cook along.
Yeah.
If you have cooked along, I hope it's been a good one. I'm going to finish this because it's so delicious. But from us, it's goodbye.
Yeah. Goodbye in the studio.
I need to stop eating that.
Oh, no! No!
What's happened now?
He's dying.
Oh.
Oh, my God. He's with my eye, man. Oh.
Anna, can you put that into the video as well?
No, wait.
Right.
I run chili all in my eye there, man. That is such a stupid thing to do.